Hi, Erwan from MotionVFX. This video is fully dedicated to mTitle Kinetic. mTitle Kinetic is a pack of 40 energetic captions that will help you to add dynamism to your edit. In this video, we'll see how these titles can be multifunctional and combinable at the same time, and how they are easy to use and intuitive. mTitle Kinetic is perfect to create Apple-style typography in your edit. Let's redo this project from scratch. First, you will find mTitle Kinetic in the title library. You will get direct access to 40 animated titles ready to use for 4K projects like this one. You can preview each animation by skimming the thumbnails. To add the title, you just have to drag and drop the title over your project, adjust the duration, and play it. By selecting the title, you can directly adjust the position, the scale, and the rotation inside the viewer with the on-screen controls. If you want to go deeper in the customization, you just have to open the inspector. I will double-click on the inspector title bar to get the full height of the Final Cut Pro interface, so you can see all the parameters at once. The parameters are divided in various sections. First, you will have access to the animations in and out that you can enable or disable. You can also find the title type parameter. This parameter will allow you to switch between various transparency settings with the typography or the background layer. So for example, I can switch to typography alpha and we will be able to see the project inside the letters. If I switch to background alpha, the background layer will be fully transparent, only the text will stay visible. I will keep the background transparent for this first title. Then you will find the position, scale, and rotation parameters that we've used with the on-screen controls. Next, you will have access to the speed parameters for the animation of the text. You will be able to choose between fast and slow, and you can adjust manually the spread parameter for the characters with the slider. The following section is for the text parameter, where you can modify the content, the color. Here I will switch to white. Of course, you can modify the font, the size, the tracking, and many more parameters. The last section is dedicated to the background layer. You can adjust all the parameters from the fade-in, fade-out animation, the position, the opacity, or create a custom gradient, for example. For this first title, I will stay with the original animation of this title number 6. Next, you will see that I've used a black solid layer inside my edit. I will use it to show you how you can combine various titles for multiple purposes. Let's add a title. I will use a preset 27, which has a nice organic animation. I will adjust the duration. I will edit the text and replace it by create. As you can see, the background layer is not a pure black. I could go to the background layer parameters to adjust the color, or I can use the title type preset as I've got a black solid layer below. So I will switch to background alpha. This could be very useful if I need to modify later on the background layer. In this case, I would just have to modify the black solid layer instead of all the titles. As I would like to get a nice flow between the various titles, I will add a new one and I will overlap it with the previous title. Titles number 9 is perfect, as it looks like it will erase the previous title. I will switch to background alpha to see the previous title and edit the text. As you can see, this title gets a color gradient that you can edit. Okay, I will overlap a third title. This time I will use a preset 24. I really like the animation, so I will use it twice to create a custom title animation. I will offset the X position to the left, just a little, like this. Now I will overlap the same title. I will set the title type to background alpha to get rid of the background. I will edit the text. This time I will offset the text to the right. Perfect. I will just need to remove the animation out on both titles, and we have our custom animation. So don't hesitate to mix titles to get unique animations for your projects. For the next title, I will show you how to customize and animate your own effect. I will use the title 39, but I could use other titles as I won't use the animation provided with the preset. I will disable animation in and out. So I just have a simple text. I will edit the text. I will switch the color of the text to black and the color of the background to white. I will set the title type to typography alpha. I've got transparency inside the letters. So now I will need to animate the scale of the text to go inside the letters. Here I will set a keyframe to 100%. I will go to the end and set a new keyframe to 1000%. To get a smoother transition, I will also add a transparency animation for the background layer with two keyframes. And we are good. For the next title, I will use the title 40. This one is composed by three titles. I will use only two. I will disable the animation out. And we are done. Again, easy to use and blazing fast. For the last title, I will use the title 20. I will edit the text and keep the default animations parameters. As you've just seen in this video, mTitle Kinetic is very versatile. You can use them directly out the box. You can adjust multiple parameters, and you can also combine them to create unique animations. To get more information, visit motionvfx.com. For more tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Ciao, ciao. Bye-bye.